So I happen to know that our next speaker does not handle praise very well, which is problematic, given he's one of the reasons why the Norfolk tech scene is as lively as it is. So one day I'm going to challenge him to get David Braben, who is a hero of mine, to come speak at Nordev, and knowing the caliber of speakers that Paul has managed to get to speak in Norwich, other people clapping at David there, I'm pretty sure I'd be able to pull it off. Now, I could thank Paul for launching my speaking career. I could list the amazing people he's introduced me to over the years. I could just play the sample of him calling me one of the best developers he knew over and over again. But unfortunately, I didn't record that. Instead, I'm just going to mock his laptop and the fact that he's currently desperately trying to get his presentation to load. And there's stress. It's okay, it's been live streamed. This is happening live. People are watching this. Are you ready? Cool, your time starts now.
Good evening. How am I going to follow that? My name is Paul Grenier, and as Dom pointed out, I run Norfolk Developers very much with Dom. I don't think he realises quite how much he does. It's really good. And I'm going to tell you a bit about Norfolk Developers, which is the group that I run with Dom. I've only got five slides. I'm going to go through what most of our main meetings and give you a flavour of what it is that we do. The aim behind Norfolk Developers has always been to bring good quality technical content to Norwich, and we do that quite well. I get bored very, very easily, so we do lots of other stuff as well. Our bread and butter is a meetup in the evening, first Wednesday of every month, which we usually hold here in one of the rooms upstairs. And we have two 45-minute sessions, usually a visiting speaker, usually a local speaker, and it's normally very, very technical. So you'll normally see code on slides, or we're talking about processes for software development, that sort of thing. That's pretty much as hardcore as we get. We started something else recently called Nordev Biz, which is a BNI-style networking event, and it's BNI-style in as much as you've got 1 minute at the table to tell everybody why you're there, what you're looking for, how to refer to you. And then one person from the group has a 15-minute spotlight to get more in-depth about their business and how you can refer to them. This is from our big dinner, which was a couple of weeks ago. That's 80 people in the library. Normally, it's just 26, but this was a big sort of recruitment drive for it. So we've got quite a good mix of people at Nordev Biz, from the techie companies to the insurance guys. I can see Chris in the audience, and Chris Sargeson over there from the Chamber is a member. And we thought it'd be a really good thing for referrals and for business, and it is, but what you really get out of it is a good time and a good meal, and it's often lots of fun. We started doing quarterly breakfast some time ago, and this was to get, this is a bit like this event, it was to get non-techie people in front of tech people, learn about tech businesses and that sort of thing. So every quarter we have a speaker, usually somebody fairly senior from a local digital company, and they come along and they talk about what they're doing. This particular photograph is from a breakfast we had with Clive Lewis a few years ago, where he came and talked about how he was going to help the tech community and that sort of thing. As well as our evening meetups, we also have full and half-day workshops, so you can come and get hands-on experience of some sort of programming, everything from learning WordPress to the latest JavaScript library or technology from Microsoft, those sorts of things. And you come, you spend a half day or a day, and you get experience from real experts, and usually you can then go and apply it to your job or other things in the world outside. Our real jewel in our crown, very much like Think Norwich's Think the City, is NordevCon, which we hold here. This is a picture that I know Harry thinks we use far too much from a few years ago, where they did the closing session of the conference, and they actually had what you can see, the exploding confetti on stage. We got in a bit of trouble with the venue because we promised we'd clear up afterwards, and we didn't. But you know, these things happen. So it's a 2.5-day event. It starts off on the Thursday with a schools day. So last year we had a load of schools in this room, all building self-standing robots and programming self-standing robots. And at the same time as that, we run some more of the hands-on workshops. I think we had an Android, a beginner's Android class that year, and a couple of other things. In the evening, we do a special event, which is 2 half-hour sessions for the people who can't come to the conference to come along and soak up some of the information from the speakers. And we normally go out to dinner in a local restaurant. Then on Friday, we all get together in here for a keynote, and then we split out into 5 sessions. So we normally have 2 techie sessions, a process or a project management type session, and a business session, which is open to everybody, and people can come in and do 90-minute workshops. Again, it goes really well. We have people along in the evening then to do for a closing keynote, and then there's a wine reception. This year, We're having the wine reception in here. We normally have in one of the other rooms, and we're going to do some lightning talks similar to what Kate was talking about with hot sauce earlier. And then we have the speakers' dinner in the evening, where all the speakers come up, and they stay seated throughout the meal. And then all the visitors, all the delegates who've come to the dinner, they get up and they move around courses, which means that you can get to talk to your favourite speaker of the day, but also all the popular speakers don't have the same person chatting away in their ear all evening. And then with hangovers and various other things, we all get up again Saturday morning, and there's another keynote, and there's five sessions again just in the morning to sort of finish off. The Saturday tends to be the really techie day. Something that's really special about the conference, which is happening next February, is that we're doing a people's track, and we're looking at mental health and other issues that a lot of software developers have. So that's something that Dom's doing, but it's going to make the conference very different and very special, I think. And we've had such a good response for people wanting to speak in it, we could almost run a whole conference just on that subject. Okay, I'm only halfway through. So who'd like to hear me say some more, and who'd like to have beer? You're a quiet audience. More. God, I've run out of slides. Okay, so the other things that we do is we also run a magazine that comes out every 6 months. Again, it's quite a range from techie articles to business articles, and we usually use it as the programme for the conference. So we print it in February, and it's just digital in September. We've done all sorts of other things in the past. We've done something called Agile on the Bench, where we all got together in a park, usually in Chapelfield, and people come and talk ad hoc about Agile, which is a type of project management process. What else have we done, Dom? We do this sort of thing, you know. So this is a, I might as well talk about that. This is a big experiment. I'm hoping it's going to help break down the barriers between the tech community and non-technical businesses. So that because we're off. The problem is, Harry. I'm conscious of the fact I'm in Norfolk, and you know that might get even worse. It's all right. I was born here. So yes, I'm hoping that that this sort of event we could do quarterly if it works for you. The one thing I've learned already this evening is to put the drinks in the middle, not at the side, to get everybody sort of in the one place where the stands are. If it's rubbish, for Christ's sake, come and tell us. If it's really good, also come and tell us and get more people along next time. I don't think I can make anything else up. Thank you very much.